Hey guys, it is Evie back in with another video, and it has been a very long time since I filmed a video. I'm wearing my green on green shirt, so don't mind me because y'all know that I'm in the military. I just wanted to talk to you guys for a little bit because I've been so busy lately. I'm just taking down my hair while I talk to you guys because these braids I put in a week and a half ago, I think. And I was just like gelling it down, making sure it's smooth for work. But I don't like how it's looking, so I'm just gonna take it out for a little and probably just wear it as a braid out for the rest of the week. Today is Tuesday, May 7th, and me and Manuel were talking about going to dinner with a couple of girlfriends, with a couple of our mutual friends, and yeah, oh my gosh, guys, there's like so much that I've been just watching on social media, like more like just YouTube specifically, and I want to put myself out there more, and I have so much footage over the course of the last like year, and I have been refraining myself from posting it because it's so all over the place, it's so disorganized in my gallery, and I've been struggling to find like the videos that I want to put together and make it a cohesive video to my liking. But I just wanted to put something out there just to do like a little quick life update. Where have I been? What's new? And just tell you guys a little bit about my life, what's going on, what I'm planning on doing. I don't want to talk too much about the future because it's always subject to change, and I don't want to talk about it until it gets closer. So yeah, okay, so let's talk about hair growth. Hair growth hasn't been my like main focus lately, but if I'm pulling from like the center, like the front of my head, y'all remember I shaved my hair back in 2016. I would have thought that my hair would have been like bust down 60 inches by now. But because of how much I don't take care of my hair or don't prioritize my hair, it's kind of in a stagnant state. I definitely have seen some hair growth. I remember when I would do a lot of hair content, my hair used to be kind of up here at my collarbone, but now it's down by my like my chest area. My hair in the back has definitely grown a lot. The hair in the front is usually where I don't pay as much love to. It goes down to about my collarbone. So my collarbone's right here. So about my collarbone, same thing with this side. The front of my hair has always been longer than the back, so I'm not too worried about how my hair is doing when it comes to like, is it growing? It is. However, I haven't been giving it as much nutrients on a consistent basis. I've been doing like protective styles here and there, but I've been thinking about changing the products I use, looking into more products that favor my hair type, because I used to use Cantu a lot in high school, in middle school, and then I shifted to Shea Moisture in high school and after high school. And then I started looking into like, okay, I need to stop complaining about my hair growth, complaining about my hair care, and I have to start investing in it. If I wanna see something moving forward, I need to start making the investments for my hair and for myself. So I tried this one, if I can find it, I'm gonna put it on the screen. I tried this one for a while. I didn't really like the consistency too much. I felt like it wasn't doing enough, and I didn't see much of an improvement. Recently, I've been using coconut oil. I've been using, I think it's Meow. I used to use like shea butter a little bit here and there on my roots, but I try not to use too much thick products because thick products will clog your pores. So I tried to stay away from like shea butter, and I use Blue Magic. It's So I use that here and there, not too much. I use tea tree oil, I use coconut oil, I use castor oil, Jamaican oil. I've tried all different, like multiple different types of oils. So I don't know what the next hairstyle is going to be as far as protective wise. For my birthday, it recently just passed. I wanted to do braids or twists. And then I even considered doing a silk press because I haven't gotten my hair pressed in a long time, in years. I haven't put a flat iron to my hair in years. But I decided not to do any of that. And then my boyfriend ended up buying me a wig, so that was a big surprise. I just braided my hair down. I washed my hair and braided it down for my birthday and wore it out. I'll put that here too. That's pretty much what's been going on with my hair. And I watch a lot of Isamé Adeko. She used to go as African Queen. I watch her a lot, and I love watching her mini twists, takedowns, mini twists, installs, just all of her hair care videos. I love watching them, and it helps me, like, it gives me reassurance that, okay, I may not see the length that I want, but at least, like, the thickness, the fullness, the strands are still there, you know. I still have hair on my head to where I'm working with it. And being in the military, I don't give a lot of love to my hair as I probably should, because I just think about the limited amount of time that I have to do my hair and how much time I could be putting into something else rather than my hair. But I would love to make it a goal for myself for the rest of this year to make better improvements towards my hair care journey. So this is my hair. I'm gonna change my top really quick, just so it's a little more flattering and we're not getting Marine Corps vibes right now. Okay, so I changed my shirt, we're all good now. I guess the next thing we could talk about is where have I been lately? So I have been traveling a lot lately. I've been focusing on work, I've been focusing on school, not last semester, but the one before, so back in like fall. I took a business management class. That was so much fun. I went in person on Thursdays and I was online for the rest of it. It was a really like straightforward class. We listened to a lot of like podcasts and discussion boards, you know, did a lot of in-person discussions, a lot of guest readers, guest speakers. And at the end of the course, you have to give an outline on your business plan and your growth and your financial plan and the audience that you're trying to reach and just everything on what your business is going to be about, basically. Don't mind my nails, by the way, because I was prying them off all week. Anyways, so that was back in December. I finished the class. I haven't taken a class yet because of how much I was traveling the few months past. So in January, end of December, beginning of January, we had went to Sequoia and celebrated Manuel's birthday. He turned 21 at the time, and we went to see the Sequoia trees. We just stayed in Airbnb for like a week. It was wonderful. It was absolutely beautiful. It was cold up there. We went up North California, and we were by ourselves. We stayed in the house most of the time. I watched Scarface for the first time. That was wonderful. I really loved Scarface. It was a really good movie. Very long, but it was really good to watch. If you guys didn't see, I posted a video on how I made oxtail for the first time. That was fun. It was scary because like, I called my mom, I called my grandmother to walk me through it all, of course. Gotta call our moms and see what that's all about. Then we hiked up to the Sequoia Mountain. Like, you drive through it. It's a big national park for those of you who don't know what Sequoia trees are and like the whole. It's a Sequoia National Park is where we went. And we stayed local about like 45, maybe like 20 to 45 minutes, I can't remember, away from where we were staying. And it was absolutely beautiful. All right, we have a lot of helicopters that fly around here. Okay, so then after that, February, what did we do? February was Valentine's Day. So I went to the field and I was in the field for like 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks. And when I came back, he surprised me with like a welcome home thing. It was super cute, super like sweet. And then March, I was preparing to go to New York and go to DR, Dominican Republic. And we had such a good time, guys. You have no idea. So we went to New York to my sister's sweet 16 and celebrated, had a good time. She looked amazing. And then for the following week was my aunt's 50th birthday. And that was just a good time too. Super like, it was kind of giving 90s themes because we were wearing denim and white. Such good vibes. She looked great, she looked amazing. And then the week after, we went to DR. This is my first time traveling to DR, so I had a wonderful time. I met like his whole other half of his family. And I was speaking a lot of Spanish. No sé mucho español, pero yo practicar, is that how you say practice? Mucho. Like I tried to practice a lot because most of his family only spoke Spanish, and I didn't want to be ignorant and not speak Spanish or not try, you know. And I've always loved the language, I've always wanted to learn fluently, but learning a whole different language as an adult is totally different than learning it as a kid. So that was frustrating the first like few days, I'm not gonna lie. I broke down a few times and we were drinking a lot. Like his family was always like offering me vodka, El Presidente. I don't know if it's El Presidente or La Presidente, I forgot. But we went and stayed with his dad. Then we went to his cousin's wedding. That was absolutely beautiful. Like, it was just all beautiful, guys. Like, I'd never been to a Catholic wedding before, so watching it had me emotional. But y'all know that I'm a very emotional person when it comes to anything, when it comes to kids' movies, when it comes to like literally life. I just love seeing life happen. I love seeing life unfold. We spent a lot of time with his younger cousins. We went to the beach, went to the pool. That like pretty much concluded DR and New York. And then we came back to Cali. And we started going back to work. Let's get into work. My career in the military, I work as a supply warehouse man. Not a lot of people talk about that MOS from what I've seen on the internet, because when I first moved out here to Cali, I remember I was looking to see if any other people talked about it. And nobody really talks about their MOSs because I guess it's more like, nobody really likes talking about their jobs or what they do or that they're in the military because they feel like it's kind of cringy or a little awkward, even though a lot of people look at us and we're like, okay, thank you for your service and we're very proud of you. But when you're enlisted, for more of the newer guys, when you first come in, they're not feeling that motivated, I guess you could say, where they're like, I represent my country, because a lot of people don't join to be a representative of the Marine Corps, of the Navy, or, well, I'll speak on the Marine Corps because I know more of that than any other branch. They just join because usually they don't know what they're doing in their life after high school. Educational purpose, financial stability, confidence, just like a lot of foundational things that you need for your life to prepare as an adult and set yourself up for your lifestyle. So that being said, going back to my career here, yeah, so I had a position in the warehouse, and at the time my roommate, she had taken that position when I was gone, and there was a whole little like a little situation where I got upset because the communication wasn't there. The position that I was like in before I left for vacay, I didn't have when I came back. I kind of was just wandering around, not really knowing what to do, where was my place in the warehouse. And right now we're having a lot of like changes. So work is okay otherwise. What else? That's pretty much a lot of what's been going on with career, with my hair, with traveling, where I've been. And I guess the last thing I could talk about is education. Like, I'm planning on going back into school. So when I make these videos, I'm literally always doing something. So it's really hard for me to like sit down and like focus on editing a video because I'm always like, what is the next thing I could do? What is the next plan I can make? What should I be preparing myself for education-wise, job-wise, financial-wise, getting myself properly equipped for whatever I want to do in life? So as far as like future career-wise, lately I've decided that I want to do dental assisting. If you guys know Aaliyah Lee, she's an RDA, registered dental assistant. She kind of inspired me to push into that field because I am interested in art. Like, you guys know, I'm interested in singing, dancing, creating, but I want to own my own business, Overflow. However, right now I don't have any like investments or amount of funds that I would like to start with, to start building and branding. So I wanted to at least start thinking about, okay, what can I think of for a steady income job to support that business. I also consider going into interior designing, which I might still do. I don't know. I'm really interested in it. I love organizing and decorating and doing all types of stuff in that field. Love watching HGTV growing up all the time. So, but the thing is with schooling, I need a lot of like certificates first and licenses to start pursuing these things. As some of you know, I also like to cut hair. I braid. That's also something that I'm trying to push into more. Something that doesn't really need much money to start, but I already have a lot of the tools to where I'm making money to support myself. I don't want to tell you guys name yet because I don't know if I've settled on that name yet, but I'm really excited about that. And I'm definitely trying to get my barbering license, which is a whole thing, but you know, it's a process. So that's where I am there. Mentally, if we're talking about mentally, I've been pretty okay lately. I've been pretty positive. I've been pretty relaxed at work when it comes to the workload because we have such a grand, let's call it staff, a grand team. We all pick up off of each other, help each other out in areas. Spiritually, I've been doing okay too. I feel like my eyes have been opened a lot in different ways to where I'm like, okay, there are different things that I need to do to grow nearer and nearer to God. There's always more like I need to do, always. But I just think about it as like, I'm taking it one step at a time and I'm trying to live my life differently, listen to more godly focused music. I still listen to like any type of music. I like music. I'm not gonna sit here and say like, oh, I'm just like this holy matrimony, but that's definitely something that I'm trying to incorporate in my life more. I try not to be shy about talking about God around people because I feel like it's something that shouldn't be gatekeeped or hidden physically. I'm hurting all the time. I'm literally always hurting. My back is always hurting. My hips are always hurting. But lately I've been pretty okay because I've been running more. And I did a PFT today, which is a physical fitness test. And I ran 25 minutes for the 3 mile. I didn't do great on the plank and push-ups. I did 45 for the plank and 35 push-ups, which is less than what I did last time, but the run is 10 times better than last time. So I don't care because running is always like hardest for me. Fitness, I haven't been too consistent because I've been going on all these trips and didn't have really the space to exercise how I would want to. Groceries haven't been amazing because we don't have money like that these days. We're waiting for that next check to kick in, and then meal prepping is gonna be incorporated more. I went to a nutritionist before I left for the vacays, so I learned a lot about like, I definitely need to intake more protein. Like, I'm always seeing all these girlies on YouTube and TikTok. They're like, oh, you need like 100 something grams of protein a day. And it's just like, that's hard, but it's what you have to do. It's literally what you have to do to get to a certain goal, to keep yourself in a certain shape. And being in the Marine Corps, I have to, because I'm currently on BCP, which is a body composition program, which is a program for people who are overweight. Typically it's for overweight, but you can be on it for underweight. But I am exceeding my max, so that sucks. But that's where we are right now. And physically though, I'm okay otherwise. As far as content creating, I just want to give a lot of my give a lot more effort into making content and just editing. I really do love making content, but when it comes to the editing portion, I haven't felt in love with it to where I can do it consistently. I love editing when I'm in it and I'm grinding and I'm going at it for hours, but it takes a while for me to actually get to the computer, get to the software and start, you know, getting in there. But I want to do more for myself, for my career. I do want to make a career out of YouTube or out of TikTok or whatever. I just want to be a content creator, if that is what God wants me to be. But we gonna find out, because maybe I just am meant to be a consumer of the content. But I like doing this. It makes me happy. It brings me joy. And I feel like I learn a lot when I watch what other people are doing, what they have to say, their life experiences and whatnot. But that's pretty much it. Like, that's pretty much what's been going on in my life lately. I just really want to make a lot more content for myself. I know that I'd like to post here and there. He's literally crawling on the floor. So extra. So I'm trying to get more into fitness training and whatnot. And I just want to see what you guys want to see from me as well, because I do a lot with my life, like I said. And I used to do a lot of car videos. So if you guys want to see some of that too, I mean, we can get into it. But yeah, that's pretty much everything that's been going on. That's my life update as of May 7th, 2024. I really appreciate you guys for making it this far in the video and watching, staying, being here with me. I hope and pray that it touches you in whatever way that it can. And that you guys just leave some suggestions on videos that you want to see down below. Comment, like, share, do whatever you gotta do. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.